Hey everyone, this is DayTraderRockStar from DayTradingRadio.com, and I'm here to bring you a nice educational video on stochastics. Stochastics, as you know, one of my favorite indicators to use to identifying overbought and oversold levels. But the truth is, stochastics were developed for a divergence indicator, and we're going to get more into that because we've got a pretty good signal recently on the coal stocks and even in some of the precious metal stocks. Just a little bit about the stochastics. I use them as my number one indicator. I use a series of five indicators to kind of determine high probability zones in the market where I want to pick up stocks or sell stocks or short stocks. I have a lot of videos on those. The core indicator would be the stochastics. I base everything off of that. I want to have those at extreme levels, or I want to have one of the signals that it's generating lining up with the other indicators. So in that case, I'm looking for an overbought, oversold, or another indicator that I'm looking, another situation I'm looking for that lines up with maybe a recognizable trend line, an underlying a recognizable pattern, another area of support and resistance, a moving average, or a reversal candlestick. These are mainly the other indicators that I'm using, and I go into detail with those on some of the webinars I do. But like I said, right now we're going to focus on the stochastics. Now the stochastics, just to give you a little history of them, they were developed by a man called George Lane in the 1950s. And basically it is an indicator that follows momentum instead of price. Now again, this is the important characteristics of this indicator, that it doesn't really follow the price, but it actually follows the speed or momentum of the price. And what the indicator was developed for is the divergence between the price and the momentum indicator, which would be the stochastic. So you actually start to see the stochastic start to change momentum as they turn back up. A lot of people use it for overbought and oversold, but the true value of this is actually managing. Again, you have a 100 mark and you have a 0 mark. And you can see when you come down to that 0 mark or underneath 10, you made a low here. And the price actually, you can see here, I want to just click on this parallel line. Right at this point, we made a low. All right, so now that we have that established, we actually make a lower low, but we actually get a little bounce in the stochastics, and then with stochastics rotate back down, but the price really makes a new lower low right here. But the stochastics, in fact, actually make a higher low. And then what that is telling you is the momentum is shifting, the momentum of the price is shifting, and that is your first clue of a reversal. So right at this point, this is why these are so good. A lot of indicators are lagging the price action. This one is pretty, you know, really forecast a reversal, and right at this point we see a big reversal in the BTU. And I say a big reversal, we have a nice downward trend here, and we have a break above previous day's highs and a follow-through day, and now we actually have a coil stochastic, which is a totally different indicator. And everything looks for a further bounce. So the key level here was that divergence. And I want to show you some examples of the divergences that happen in other things. You know, also doing this video for Mr. Top Step, in association with Mr. Top Step. And, you know, this great site focuses a lot on the futures, the S&P futures in general. And I use the stochastics a lot with my S&P future trades. One situation I like to do is follow the S&P cash, or and in some cases the SPY, which is the ETF that tracks the S&P 500. And, you know, we actually had a great example of that, so I'm going to actually go back and show you that example right now. All right, here we're taking a look. We're going to start off taking a look at the SPY, which is the ETF that tracks the S&P 500. You can see this is a recent bull flag, the breakout, the move higher. Stochastics now pushed up into an overbought level, but this is not the... you know, this is not the lesson today. The lesson is about the divergence in the the stochastic price divergence. So I'm going to go all the way back here to the last really big buy signal in the market, which was back here in June. And June, you can see a nice little pullback before we started this pretty decent rally here. And when we look for a pullback, we recognize a couple different indicators. One of the things that I like to look at in a pullback is the underlying trend line. Underlying trend line, lots of people think it'll be a supporting trend line that's moving up, but I like to actually concentrate on any type of channel line or a trend line that's developed by multiple pivot areas. And pivot areas are defined as points in the market where really the markets make a recognizable move either from a lower point to a higher point, or from a higher point to a lower point, lower point to a higher point, etc. These areas become pivots, and when these pivot areas connect, you could draw a straight line and really concentrate. And once you have two pivot areas and draw that straight line, then the third one really becomes a focus point to take that trade. Now, you know, that's one of the main, the second main indicator I take a look at. So we combine both the stochastics and the underlying trend lines. In this case, a lower, a trend line that which represents a downward trend, which is the kind I love. But the key here is also following the stochastics. Now, the stochastics here on the SPY, you can see we actually got oversold. You know, again, I wanted to put this little parallel line in here to represent here we got oversold right here. And we got really pinned down into an oversold level. At that point, we got a little bounce, and then we actually came back and made a very extreme, we definitely made a lower low here. All right, you can see the, bring this over here. You can see that lower low is definitely defined here. But and it's definitely defined that we're making a higher low on the stochastic. So this right here is the golden ticket here in divergences between stochastics and price. This is what you want to look for. This is, a kind of a rare event. You know, it happens, but it really marks a major point in a stock or an index that's making a move like this. This is how the stochastic developed to be used. And when it does give you a signal like this, it's a very powerful signal. And from that point on, you could actually see that was a really good rally from that point on, and then continue to push up here. And now if we actually took a look at the S&P, the SPX, we could actually see that also. I'm just going to move this over here fast. You can see here on the SPX, the same thing. It's just, you know, basically the low right here, the real, and then the lower low, but the higher low in the stochastics right here. A very key indicator, a great indicator. All right, so getting back to the current trade, and how do we use the stochastic price divergence indicator for current trades right now? This will work across the board, stocks, futures, and ETFs. What I like to do is actually, I've been following the gold trade, and I just noticed that recently we actually had that type of divergence. You could actually see it on individual stocks. All right, we're going to take a look at AEM for the first example. It's a mining stock. And again, you could actually start to see, get some of these lines out of here. What we had is a low here, stochastic low, a low there, and then we had a lower low, but a higher low on the stochastics right here. So we actually had that stochastic divergence right now. So we're going to see if we actually get this move here up and out of this. This is a very bullish setup here on the gold stocks. Gold GLD, very similar, except we didn't make a lower low here, but this is still a very good signal that we're making a higher low, and we actually made a higher low on the stochastics, and actually a coil stochastic indicator right now, which is a different topic, but I also have an educational video on that if you want to just look up coiled stochastics, DayTrader Rockstar on YouTube. So again, all these basic material stocks seem to be setting up for a move, and that's why, you know, I wanted to really focus on the stochastic divergence setup for this week, and this will be the first video that I'm doing on this particular indicator. That involves the stochastics. The stochastics, again, you could take the stochastics as an overbought to oversold. You could take it as a divergence. You could take, there's many ways of reading into the stochastics. Here we have a coil stochastic, which I showed people the other day on my trade. We had a nice coil stochastic. We took a position here based off of everything we just talked about, and we got a nice bounce on this. This happens to be one of the focus stocks going into this upcoming week, so continue to watch the coal stocks. Just to give you one more example, I just happened to see it playing on the video here next to me. I was doing watching an old video of mine, and I just noticed that there was another divergence back here in NCR back last October. Just to show you another fast example of what you want to look for. Again, you have right here a low in the stochastics, and you have a low in the price target right here. And then they have a nice little bounce, but you have a breakdown in the lower low. But you have a hold, you're holding above the recent low here. So that's the divergence. And from that, usually that divergence comes into a pullback. You know, there's other things you look at, nice little wedge pattern. But overall, that really gives you that divergence playing out here. And then from that point on, you really have a nice rally. Also, Gold Corp recently, just now, setting up in the same way. We have a low here. You have a little lower low here, but a higher low here, and it continues to look like we're starting to base out here. Now, there's a lot of things that affect the markets, and you know, you can't take everything, you know, as law. These are all probability setups, you know, based on patterns, indicators, and stuff. If there's outstanding or outside influences, news, events, these patterns break down. So always remember, these are not foolproof, but they do give you a better probability in the market. And that's what we do here. Look for the highest probability setups in the market. So hope you enjoyed this video. Continue to trade well, and I will talk to you guys soon. It's very nice. And again, I'm Day Trader Rockstar for DayTraderRadio.com, and I'll see you next week.